Hi everyone and welcome back to another art journal video. In the coming weeks I'm planning to share many Christmas themed art journals and I have a bunch of new products here. Most of them are by Tim Holtz and I will be using lots and lots of those in my art journals that are coming up. So today I'm going to start with some of them and I just want to let you know that there is a great sale on the Tim Holtz brand. Everything is 20% off and you will find the link to that down below in the description area. So I got some collage paper, I got washi tape, lots and lots of C6 dies by Tim Holtz, which I absolutely adore the designs. I also got some ephemera and many chipboard sentiments and a bunch of other products from the new Christmas collection. Now for today I'm going to mainly play with this C6 die, which is absolutely adorable. The moment I saw the design, I knew I had to turn it into an art journal page. It gives you a die to cut out that little elf, as well as lots of dies to cut out gifts and the bits and pieces. Now, here is a standard card size that's 4.25 by 5.5, so you can see that it makes a great focal point for a card. However, I'm going to use it on my art journal and I am going to play on a 6x6 art journal. This is the disc bound one that I have. So I have already cut out a 6x6 watercolor paper. This is nice and thick. And I'm going to place that on top so you can see the size and compare. You can see that it makes a great focal point for a 6x6 journal. And if you are working on an art journal book, then that size is perfect as well. I'm going to put the dies aside for now and I will work on my background. So again, this is watercolor paper and I'm going to cover it up with this collage paper. This is by Tim Holtz and it has a lovely design. Now I want to have some of that colorful design on my page, but I don't want it to be centered and definitely not covering up the whole part. I need to have some white space as well. So I'm trying to figure out which part I'm going to use, and once I'm happy with the placement, I'm going to use my scissors, cut out a part of it, and then it's time to stick it down. For sticking down my collage paper, I'm going to use Distress Collage Medium. I'm going to open it up for you so you can see the color. This works exactly like matte medium, but it has a tint on it. And since I'm going for an art journal with a vintage look and feel, I prefer to use this as my glue. So you can see here how it adds some color at the background. I'm going to cover it up completely with my brush and then place on top the paper. Now, if you get some wrinkles, it doesn't really matter. These are all going to flatten up once I use my brush on top. And also remember that wrinkles add texture and more interest on your background, so it's not something that you want to avoid. I get a lot of questions about the brushes. I just dip them in water and I leave them there until I finish the project, where I go to the sink and wash them nicely. So now I'm going to make sure that the matte medium is completely dry. I'm using my new embossing tool. This has two settings. The first one is for drying out things so it's not as hot, and the second one is super hot for embossing. I'm going to use my scissors to cut off the excess collage paper. For that you can also tear it off if you want to have rough edges. And I'm going to create a border with white gesso. I'm using a flat brush and I'm working from the outside towards the center. I'm not going to cover it up completely, obviously. I just want to have a nice white border that fades out towards the center. The gesso I'm using is by Faber-Castell and it doesn't completely cover up the design since it is quite thin. But of course, if you want to completely cover up the design at the edges, then you can use a thicker gesso or just add more layers of the thin gesso that you have at home. Now this is where I decided to add some splashes with the gesso that I have on my table. I'm going to dilute it with water. At the finished project, I will not have any of those white splashes that I'm going to add now. However, I decided to leave that part of the video on so you can see the different stages and how we can change our mind as we go. And in any case, if I decided to add more splashes, I could have done that when the project was finished. Now I'm going to do some inking. I have my Distress Oxide ink here and that's Vintage Photo, and this is where I decided that I wanted the main part of the paper to be quite darker. And that's where I completely covered up the splashes, but again you can always add them at the end. Now I'm trying to decide where this elf is going to go, and you can see here the bug is very busy, so I'm going to turn it one more time and try to decide where this is going to look better. I don't want to have a busy background, otherwise it's not going to help the elf to stand out. Now I think this is the best placement, however, if you look at it like that, the word Christmas is upside down. I don't care about this detail at all. I will find a way to cover it up so that it's not readable later on. Now these are design tapes. They come in a pack all together and they have lovely designs, very Christmassy ones. I'm going to pick a few of them, a couple of them, to work with on my page, and the idea here is to create kind of a ground where I'm going to place the elf standing on top so that it doesn't look as if it is floating. I'm also going to bring in one lovely sticker from this sticker pack. So I'm going to tear a few pieces and place them one on top of the other to create a cluster of washi tape. And I always make sure that the edge on the inside of the paper is not completely straight. I always like to have a rough edge as it adds more to the project. Now, just because I have matte medium underneath, it is very forgiving, so if I don't like the placement of those washi tapes, I can always peel them off and place them in another area. And you will see that I'm going to do that later on. If you want to make sure that this is not removable, then just use some glue underneath. Now, as I tear off the side of this sticker, you can see the white. And as I tear off the side of this sticker, you can see the white core coming through. If you don't like that, just like I didn't like it, you can always use your blending tool and add a bit of vintage photo to cover it up. And this is where I changed my mind, and you can see how easily I can peel it off and place the whole cluster of washi tapes just a bit lower on my project. And of course you can add some glue at the back to make sure that they are nicely secured there. Now I'm applying some collage medium at the back of the elf, and then I'm going to stick him on top of my project. And I absolutely love the silhouette. If I had to choose just one of the new Sizzix and Tim Holtz dies, then I would definitely go with this one. Now I'm going to embellish my art journal a little bit more, and I'm going to use some of the phrases from this sticker pack. I'm going to place them just underneath his feet. This one says, "Be good for goodness sake." And just because one is never enough, I'm going to use one more, which is the Deck the Halls one. And I'm slightly inking them up to help them blend with the rest of the background. And now it's time to do some more die cutting. For that I will use the rest of the dies from the Santa Helpers die set. And I used some colored cardstock to cut out all the pieces. I'm going to assemble three boxes, three gifts. For that I'm using my Nouveau Deluxe glue. I like that because it has a very fine tip, and at the same time it is great because when it dries it is completely transparent. So any white glue that you see at the moment, it's going to completely disappear. The color combo that I went with is green and red, and I throw in a little bit of yellow as well. Now another fun part about this die set is that you can use it all year round. Just because it gives you the dies to create those gifts, you can use them to create birthday cards in any color combo that you like, and it gives you also bows. Oh, and by the way, if you are wondering how I know exactly where I am supposed to stick all those tiny pieces, it is really easy because when the big dies cut out, they also create little crease lines. So I'm going to place them here, trying to decide where everything is going to go. So once I decide where everything is going to go, I'm going to remove everything and do some inking. These are little details that really make a huge difference and helps everything come together. So I inked up the background to help all those elements to stand even more. And I'm also inking up the edges. These are going to make again a huge difference and help them stand out against the background, especially this yellow gift, which is pretty much the same color as the background. Now I'm going to make this a tiny smaller so that it allows some space for the bow at the top. and I'm sticking everything down by using glue. Of course, you can use your collage medium if you like. And as I'm looking at this at the moment, I think that you can turn this elf into a boy for a birthday card holding all those gifts if you cut out the tail on his hat as well as the tips on his shoes. So it is really versatile and you can use it all year round. Now this is how I'm going to cover up the upside down Christmas world, and I just stuck down a sticker that says all is calm, all is bright. I'm also going to use a few more stickers on the other side just to balance it a little bit and create a triangle, a visual triangle of stickers. And this time I used Merry Christmas and filling our stockings. Now, one of the things that I absolutely love doing on my art journals is adding some highlighting. For that, I'm using my gel pen and I'm adding here and there some white lines. And I'm doing that on some parts of Santa's helper, and I'm also going to do that on the gifts. These highlights are so tiny, but at the same time they bring a lot of difference on the page and helps all those elements to stand out. The pen that I'm using here is the Jelly Roll by Sakura. The color is bright white and it writes beautifully, as you can see. Just make sure that everything is completely dry underneath. Now I'm going to do a finishing touch, which I think really brings everything together. This is one of the new stencils by Tim Holtz. I'm going to place a stencil on one side of my page and apply some paste with my spatula. I picked up a small spatula so that I can easily control how much I add. I'm not going to completely cover up the whole space. I just want to have those stars around the perimeter. I'm going to clean my stencil before I go to the other side and repeat the same process one more time. Now I have white stars over the white border, which gives a great texture, and at the same time I do allow some of the stars to come towards the center. Just because the stencil is semi-transparent, I can easily see where my elf is, and I'm making sure that I don't cover him up with stars. And I am also careful as I add the stars at the bottom, making sure that they don't cover up the washi tape. Now, another thing that you can do is to use gold embossing paste instead of white. Or while the embossing paste is still wet, you can sprinkle some glitter, which is going to stick on the stars and add some sparkle. And here is the finished project for today. You can punch some holes and put it back on your disc-bound journal, or leave it as it is and frame it, as it is going to make a beautiful Christmas decor. And here are some close-up photos on the project for today. And don't forget that everything that I used by Tim Holtz is 20% off for just a few days. You will find the links on everything I used down below in the description area. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired. Don't forget to like and subscribe and share this video with your friends if you had fun watching. Thank you all so much, and I'll see you all next time.